He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Okay, let's practice measuring specific heat. So the question says, a 59.7 gram piece of metal is transferred from boiling water. So it started out in boiling water, and then we're going to put it in 60.0 milliliters of water that is initially at 22.0 degrees Celsius. If the final temperature of the system, so the metal in the cold water, ends up at 28.5 degrees Celsius, what is the specific heat of the metal? So here's all the information. We've got that hot metal that started in boiling water, and we know what temperature boiling water has to be. And we put it in that cold water, and it goes from 22 to 28.5. And we want to find the specific heat. So if this is daunting, go ahead and check out my tutorial on thermochemistry and specific heat and heat transfer. And that will outline what you need to do for this kind of problem. And when you're ready, give it a try. Okay, so let's split this up into two parts. First, we want to see what happened with the water, and then later we'll see what happened with the metal. So looking at the water, let's set up our equation. So we know that this equation is the one that we're going to want to use. So Q, or heat, is equal to C, or specific heat, times mass times delta T, or the change in temperature. So the heat absorbed by the water is going to be equal to the specific heat of water times the mass of water times the change in temperature that the water experienced. And the change in temperature, of course, is TF minus TI, or the final temperature minus the initial temperature. So plugging things in, Q is going to be equal to the specific heat of water, which is 4.186 joules per gram degree Celsius, and that's a tabulated value. We would just get that out of the textbook or online. That is just known data. Times the mass of the water, and we had 60 milliliters of water, and water is 1 gram per milliliter, so 60 milliliters is the same thing as 60 grams, so we can just call that 60 grams of water. And then the change in temperature, or T final minus T initial, remember that the water ended up at 28.5 degrees Celsius. That was the final temperature. That's what it got heated up to. And then the initial temperature, we subtract the initial temperature from the final temperature, it started out at 22.0 degrees Celsius before we put the metal in there. So that is the equation that gives us how much heat was absorbed by the water. And if we do the arithmetic, we get 1,630 joules. That's to 3 sig figs. Now, the important thing to understand is that the heat that was absorbed by the water is the heat that was released by the metal. So we have conservation of energy, right? The metal got heated up and we put it in the water and it transferred energy into the water. So all of the heat that was absorbed by the water is precisely the heat that was released by the metal, or at least that's what we're going to assume in an idealized situation. So we can do another calculation with that same amount of heat with the metal. So let's take this equation again. Q, or the heat released by the metal, is equal to C, the specific heat of the metal this time, times M, the mass of the metal, times delta T, or T final minus T initial, for the metal rather than the water. So this is a new equation, and we're looking at the metal specifically. So Q, we know, it is going to be the opposite of the heat absorbed by the water. So instead of 1,630 joules, we have negative 1,630 joules. That is the heat that was released by the metal. Now that is going to equal C, which we will leave as C because we do not know it yet. That is what we're going to solve for. So we'll leave that as C, times M, which is 59.7 grams. That was the mass of the metal that was given to us, times the change in temperature for the metal. Now, for this, we have to understand that the T final is 28.5 degrees Celsius. Remember that the system as a whole equilibrated to 28.5 degrees Celsius. That was the water with the metal in it. So those together ended up at 28.5 degrees Celsius, all as a whole. So that we have the same final temperature for the water and the metal. But from that, we must subtract the initial temperature of the metal, and we're going to call that 100 degrees Celsius because that was sitting in boiling water, and water must be 100 degrees to boil, so we're going to call that 100 degrees Celsius. So that is our change in temperature for the metal. So if we go ahead and do the arithmetic, we can solve for C. That's going to be negative 1,630 joules over the quantity 59.7 grams times negative 71.5 degrees Celsius. That's why it's important to do T final minus T initial, because we need a negative delta T in order to cancel out the negative Q value to give us a positive specific heat. Remember, we're going to need a positive number for specific heat. A negative number wouldn't make any sense. So we need a negative delta T there. So we plug all that into the calculator and we get 0.382 joules per gram degree Celsius as the specific heat of this metal.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, support me on Patreon so I can keep making content, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.